Hello and welcome to Ricky's Tech Talk. In this basic how-to video, I'm going to show you how to set up your brand new MacBook Pro. So let's begin. As soon as you lift the lid for the first time, you'll hear the famous Apple chime and it will load into the setup process. Once you've loaded up, it will then welcome you in a range of different languages, starting with hello. All you need to do is use your force trackpad to press get started, and then you'll move on to the next section. Just a side note here, you can use Apple's own voiceover to help through the setup process.
To use English as the main language, press the return key.
The next step is asking you to choose your region. We're going to select United Kingdom. The next step shows a wide range of accessibility settings that Apple has implemented, which is really nice to see. So we've got vision options, you have motion options, you have hearing options, and you have cognitive options to choose from. And I'm just going through these, showing them now. So it talks about the keyboard. You can also zoom in as well. If you're vision impaired, you can use the voiceover. You can change the way the screen looks. You can have subtitles, and also you can change the way you use your MacBook Pro. And you can even talk to it if you need to. And then finally, you can actually choose if you want a light theme, a dark theme, or change depending on the time. So it's really nice to see all these settings here. So let's continue. The next step then asks you to choose your Wi-Fi connection and connect to your internet at home. So make sure you know your password and enter your password here, and then you can move on to the next step. Then we move on to the data and privacy agreement from Apple, which you need to agree to use their services and of course use the MacBook Pro. You use this next step to migrate from either a Windows PC or laptop, or even from a previous Mac. So you can either use your iCloud backup, you can use a Time Machine backup, and then finally you can actually choose not to do anything and set up as a brand new MacBook, which I'm going to do today. This next step will ask you to sign in with your Apple ID. So you need an Apple ID to use all of Apple's services, such as great FaceTime apps, to use messages, to use the App Store, to use the iTunes Store, to buy Mac apps if you need to. So if you don't have an Apple ID, you can create your own. There's a simple process just by clicking create Apple ID, and it will show you how to do that. Also in this stage, you can choose to use two separate accounts for different services from Apple as well. So it's up to you what you choose here. And then of course you have Apple's terms and agreements, which you have to agree to use all of their services. After you have agreed to Apple's terms and conditions, you are then asked to create an account for your MacBook Pro. So just put in your name, put in a password if you choose a password. Really recommend using quite a strong password. And also there is a box here that allows you to put a hint in for your password, so you don't have to write it down on a scrap of paper. Next, you have the ability to link your MacBook Pro to the Find My application that may be linked to your iPhone or iPad, or you can now even create your own Find My account if this is your first Apple product. So Find My identifies where your product is, and if becomes lost or stolen, you can lock it down remotely. This next section is called Make This Your New Mac, and this is where it talks about app analytics, it talks about location services, device analytics, Siri, screen time, and what you can do is go through and select which ones you want to use, what they're about, and how they work for you, or you could even turn them off if you wish to. Then we move on to Touch ID. So Touch ID is built into the power button for your MacBook Pro. And Touch ID can be used to unlock your MacBook Pro once a finger or multiple fingers have been registered. It can be used for buying applications or even buying online. If you're shopping on your favorite store and they have Apple Pay, what you do is you register your fingerprint, as I'm showing on screen now, by just placing your finger up and down and it registers a fingerprint, but use Apple Pay as well. You'll need to link the cards, which comes up in the next section, and you can link your bank card if you choose to. As I've just mentioned, this is the section now where you register your bank card. So they may come from your iPhone or iPad if you've already had them registered, or you can register a new bank card to use Apple Pay. That's for the Mac App Store and also to use online. Finally, the setup process has completed. You may get some pop-up windows just asking for permission about locations or to use certain applications such as calendar or weather. But then you are greeted with your new home screen here for your MacBook Pro, and you get to use the MacOS Monterey, which is the latest version of macOS. This compares maybe to Windows 11 or Windows 10 if you're moving from Windows, but don't worry, we'll talk about this more in future videos. I really hope this video has helped you set up your brand new MacBook Pro or even answer some questions through the setup stage. However, if you do have any questions or queries, please leave a comment below and I will be there to help. Thank you so much for watching, and make sure to subscribe to Ricky's Tech Talk to stay updated with any future videos on the MacBook Pro. And from me, stay safe, stay well, and I will see you in my next video.